Shalom, this is Rabbi David Idenson, author of the book Secret of the Scale on Human Relations. Our website is secretscale.com. Our topic today is abuse of abuse. We know there is child abuse. We know there is domestic abuse. What we don't know, what many people don't know, is that this idea of calling the police on somebody claiming they are molesting, a domestic abuse or abuse of children, has now become a tool for false abuse, and it gives people the advantage of revenge. And also in divorce cases, where the woman calls the police on her husband, it gives her an advantage when she's going through a divorce in the courts. And therefore, there is a problem with false reporting about abuse. There is today a bill going through the New York State Assembly to prevent false reports about abuse, claiming that a person molested children or molested his wife domestically, whatever, or in any kind of abuse. It's New York State Assembly Bill AO5008, and it says establishes guidelines for the conduct of child protective investigations following a report of child abuse or neglect, requires an investigator to clearly identify the reason for or purpose of the investigation and to apprise the parent or other guardian of their rights and obligations, requires investigator, where possible, to record an interview at the physical exams conducted by a physician. What promoted this law was a lawsuit brought about by someone, a fine, decent man, and with fine, decent children. And one day, social services arrives at this house and no one's home, and they run to the school and they say, "We're from Child Protective, and we are investigating abuse on this child and that child," right in front of the school, in front of people. They come, and they strip search and to see if they have any bangs or wounds or whatever. So what happened was like this, that the social service worker was looking for somebody based on a telephone call. In New York State, there's such a thing as hotlines. Anybody in the world could call up the hotline without leaving their name, not leaving any way to check out the veracity of the complaint, and say, "Mr. X is abusing his children." And right away, the social worker runs in there, and the CPS is there. "Okay, you're a suspected child molester. Let's see your children and strip search them and see if there's any bangs or whatever." It just so happened that in this particular case, they promoted the Assembly Bill A05008, it just so happened that there was some kind of a bang because the girl was playing softball and got banged. So, maybe your father banged you? Anyway, the father went to court and the judge was furious and he said, "What is this?" First of all, the family that they were investigating, the person that called up on the phone, told about a family that begins with the letter A, and this family was B, it was Beck. And second of all, there are other reasons. It says the person had three daughters, and this man had a daughter and a son, and this family had a different type of children. So obviously it was a complete error. It wasn't the right name of the family, and it wasn't the right type of children or amount of children. So if the social worker had half a brain, they would have run away, but they found the mistake, or they would have found the right place in the first place. But no, they went to the school in front of everybody. So the judge agreed that this was a very egregious case of governmental overreach, and there's a whole article on it, in the New York Times, December 4th, 1990, called "Family Nightmare: A False Report of Child Abuse." And then Judge Vincent Broderick of Federal District Court said that, called it an outrage, and he said anybody could have this outrage. All someone has to do is go on the phone, on the hotline, and leave a false message. "This Mr. X is a child molester," and the next day, they're out there. This is outrageous. He said it's outrageous. And then, not long ago, there was a settlement of this case. Westchester Social Services had to pay a huge amount of money to Mr. Beck for the pain of his children and the suffering. And Finally, what happened was that the assembly itself understood that this is an outrage, as the judge said it was an outrage, and they're making now a law that the to try to rein in the investigators. Well, let's understand, the investigators are not beasts or animals that want to go around hurting people. Just the opposite. They're idealists. They want to prevent abuse. Now, when you're an idealist and you're a zealot, you could overstep your bounds. And that obviously is what happened here. People overstepped their bounds, and the New York State Assembly is now trying to pass law AO5008 that would somehow rein in the zealots. But not just rein in the zealots. It would give a way of really clarifying a procedure of searching for abuse in a proper way. So this is the latest news about child abuse. I want to say that I've been involved in family issues and marriage issues and all types of divorces. And this type of false claim of abuse is a very powerful weapon, and it is used. It seems to be that there's all types of, in America, fathers' movements and trying to defend themselves against these things. For many years now, the wife could say anything in the world, not just the wife. If you claim that you're being victimized or you're afraid of people, the zealots jump in. One of the most egregious cases was, I think, the ones that sometimes suffer from this are the big, the famous people. I think there was one of these, some major television star that we lived in New York, and somebody in Arizona claimed that he harmed her with some kind of witchcraft or something. She had some kind of ridiculous claim that he was somehow damaging her, and he wanted to go to Arizona, and there was a whole problem there. She made a complaint against him, and he had to get a lawyer to defend himself. So this obviously that the zealots want to protect people, and it's really, as we found in New York State, the zealots can overdo things. And it can become a little bit ridiculous. These are the claims, and anyway, these are claims. I wasn't there to see if all these claims are true or not true, or if they actually happen. But this is the father rights people claim that these things are happening. And there are organizations and websites both ways. Undoubtedly, there is all types of abuse going in either direction. And the state very often does want to protect women who are very often beaten. And it does happen. They want to protect children who are very often beaten. And sometimes they do too good of a job. They, anybody who says that someone molested somebody, go get them and torture them and shame them and harass them. Like, go after their children. And I mean, the children, this was a Beck family in New York that had this false accusation. The children had nightmares afterwards that their father and mother were going to be taken away from them. So this was really an egregious case of false abuse. We have to realize what is happening in America when we deal with the problems of minorities. We have to make sure that we help people without destroying other people that don't deserve to be destroyed. And we have to be very careful about the zealots. Once we let people run around in the name of the state, in the name of the law, doing whatever they want and making children have nightmares and doing other things, we are not doing the right thing.